I think the music started early today. 22 minutes before 12 o'clock. Joe Martone is running into the studio, as is Robin McBlain, and they will be playing in just a second. That's okay. That's okay. We got time. We got time. We got time. Calm down. Calm down.
Let me see if my bell works. I'm okay.
Let's see. We have something we need to mention first. Where's that note you gave me this morning?
What? Who? What? Where? We got prizes again?
We do have prizes, yeah.
Oh, good.
Come on, Joe. How you doing, Joe?
I'm busier than a one-armed paper hanger. I'm going to be at the mall tonight.
You're going to be at the mall? What are you doing at the mall?
What are you doing?
It's girls' night out tonight.
What are you doing there?
At the mall?
At the mall, 5:30 to... 5:30 it starts, 6 o'clock.
Girls' night out.
Wow, what
girls
time? 5:30 to...
5:30 to 8, I think.
Till 8. And where are you going to be?
First I'll be in front of Macy's, where they're going to have their fashion show.
Okay.
And then I'll be in front of Belk's, and there's going to be vendors there and everything. You can go on there online. Or you can call them up with questions. It's 2371223.
Okay,
and
excellent.
Bug the heck out of them. Say, hey, I heard at WOCA something's going on.
Yeah.
We'll put
that'll
you on
fun.
Facebook.
Hey, let's have some fun with them.
Yeah.
Call up 2371223. I think that's the correct number.
You think?
I'm going off the top of my head here.
All right.
Putting it on Facebook, better be.
Let me look. Hang on. I'll look at it. But what I'm saying is you give them a call. Ask for Ashley.
Uh-huh.
And then say, I heard on WOCA you have a girls' night out tonight. What's happening?
All right.
And bug the heck out of her.
At the Paddock
Mall.
Right,
let's see.
He's going
to
do it.
Didn't you tell me to do it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Ashley is her name. See if she's there. Rose will probably answer, though.
Hey, Joe.
Hey.
How are you?
Hey.
Who would you like to talk to?
That's no fun. You know you're
it's
on
your
the air.
I am on the air. Okay,
so
wonderful.
So be careful what you say.
Okay.
I was going to have some fun with Ashley, but I guess I can't have some fun because you know it's me.
Yes.
Is she there?
She's getting it ready for the event for tonight.
Oh, she's not there.
We're having girls' night out tonight at the mall from 6 until 9 p.m. We're having a fashion show, goodie bags, raffles. It's going to be lots of things, so we want to invite all your listeners to come.
You're
going to
work me hard. Is that what you're saying?
How's that say? You said I was on the radio.
So why'd you invite Joe?
I already did that. Yeah,
why'd you invite Joe if it's girls' night out? I don't understand this.
Not Joe.
Oh, you didn't invite Joe? Who'd you invite?
All his friends.
Oh, your friends. Joe's got a lot of girlfriends? Is that what you mean?
You're going to get me in trouble. Patsy's listening, and I'm in deep trouble.
Patsy would be mad at me.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah.
Well, she comes with me anyway.
So is Joe singing?
I bet.
No.
Is Joe singing?
No.
Yeah, he does karaoke.
No.
He's wonderful.
He does
wait a minute.
Okay.
You didn't know? He didn't tell you he sings?
Well, I heard him sing before. He has a wonderful voice.
Oh, so is he going to sing
tonight?
Oh,
thank you so much. No, yes. Not tonight.
Women like those deep, timberish voices.
Sure.
Halloween, we'll sing. During Halloween, on the 27th when I come back.
All right. Okay. So what time is it tonight?
It is 6 to 9 p.m.
All right.
And a lot of the events take place right in Center Court, the concourse.
Is it okay?
The concourse.
Are you allowed to invite a shopaholic into a mall?
Sure, why not?
All right, Larry, I'm going to take your line here.
The more, the merrier.
to get in there,
okay.
We go in where the sign says food court,
right?
And then you walk right by the WOCA commissary,
okay?
And then you walk straight ahead, correct?
Right.
There we go.
Yeah.
See, I already got her.
Sure.
We already know it's a WOCA commissary.
Get services. Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you so much. We needed to promote that, and this was the best way to do it.
Boy,
thank you very much.
Sneaky.
Alrighty.
All right. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
She knew
what was nice.
She knew it was you right away, Joe.
Right, that's no fun.
She knew it was you.
I have to disguise the voice next time.
Yeah, I don't think.
You know what? I shouldn't have said anything. You should have just called.
You should have called up and used that little device with a Halloween skull that has your voice.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
She would have thought it was you.
What does that say? I forget what it says again.
Hey there.
Hi there.
Hey there. Hi there.
Where are you going? Where are you going? I see you. That's what it says. I see you. Where are you going?
All right, today we have a prize. Are you ready?
How about time, I guess. I'm sorry. I get on tangents, don't I?
No.
Tangents.
Tangents!
All right, look.
Second floor, tangents.
Joe,
yes.
I have seen you in a pink bra.
Yes, you have.
And it sparkled, too.
Smorgle.
Yeah, sparkled.
And Joe donned that pink bra for...
How do you don
it? For a good cause.
Donned. You're talking to the Don here.
Joe wore the pink bra for
thank you.
Good reason.
Yes, I did.
It was for the Susan G. Komen for the Cure, right?
Correct.
It was part of the Save the Tatas thing?
Yes, Save the Tatas.
And you had no problem with that?
No.
I'm man enough to. And we have here a double prize. We have
That's cute.
We have a double prize.
Cute.
We have here a pink Pashmina scarf.
Oh.
Featuring the breast cancer awareness ribbon. It's worth $25. Nice looking scarf. Look at that.
Let me see.
It has fringe on it.
Here, let me throw it to you.
So, hey.
Go ahead. If you're looking online, you'll see Joe holding it.
It's a little thing there.
Logo.
Do you want to fashion it?
There you go.
You want to model it?
There it is. There's a logo on it. So you can win this $25 scarf.
And you'll also get, if you win today, you'll win the buzzword game, which is a game we actually converted to be an on-air game, but this is it's still shrink-wrapped. It's made by the Patch Game Company. It's called Buzzword.
Wait a minute. They already got in touch with me. Do you know that? Seriously.
So it's a board game called
royalties.
Buzzword.
I hope so.
Buzzword.
And it's fun. We've played it before. We haven't played it in a while, but you can have a copy of it if you win. Now, here's what you need to do. You need to bet on Robin and Joe. We need two players. Today, do you know what the theme is today?
Should we try, Robin? I'll say famous monuments.
No.
In Canada.
No, gee, no.
Wow, he throws me these curves.
I'll do that one tomorrow.
No. No, that was a joke.
I have here music from Disney World.
Your job is to
tell me where these songs are played.
You know how hard that is, Robin, to do?
No, you're going to ace
it.
Let me tell you something.
When I had this idea, I had no idea how much music was actually in Disney World.
That's what I'm saying. She said, oh, you're going to ace this. She has no idea.
I really didn't know.
Every ride and everything. Every place. And they have smells that they shoot out there. Did you know that? They actually have smells.
I smelled some things, yeah.
Yeah.
No, I mean, on purpose.
That was on purpose?
They push smells out, yes, wow. In different areas and different...
So after Aerosmith ride with Robin, that was all intentional?
That was a different kind of smell. Oh, wow. Disney didn't supply that. Disney did not supply that.
Yeah, I was wiped out after that.
Yeah, no, Disney didn't supply that, supply that smell.
Grass.
No, but from what I understand, they put out pine smells. Fresh smells, depending.
Makes sense. I mean, the guy knew.
Makes sense. That was good.
Listen. When I go to a movie,
he doesn't even take credit for when he gets a good one.
Because you caught it. It was an accident. So it was an accidental joke. When I go to a movie and I leave the movie, sometimes I will go, "Wow, that was a great movie."
Mm.
And then I'll go to the store to see if I can find, well, back in those days, find the soundtrack. Right?
Oh yes, yeah. They still do that.
And then I'll hear the soundtrack. And I'll go, wow, that is really a good soundtrack. And then I'll think about the story of the movie. I'll think, you know what I really liked? I think it was the music more than the movie.
Oh, the music makes the movie sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah. And Disney knew this.
Oh.
I mean, Disney has music everywhere. It's amazing how many places he's
played. And how it is directed.
When you
walk 5 feet, you don't hear this.
When he titled his show, The Wonderful World of Color.
Oh, yes.
Because he understood the importance of color. He also could have called it The Wonderful World of Music, because music plays such a huge role in everything he's done.
That's right. Well, did you know Disney, when he started his programs, although television was in its infancy in 1955, it's still young, although it started way back when, they were still broadcasting in black and white.
Yeah.
But he filmed everything in color.
Just to be prepared.
To be prepared.
For the day. Yeah. All right, so I have here music from Disney World.
Oh, Robin we're and Joe will have with this
to,
one.
Robin and Joe will have to guess where these songs are heard. That's the only thing you have to guess. But if you guess the additional information, like the title of the song,
or the artist,
some of them have artists, some of them don't name the artist, you'll get additional points. So we'll kind of do that way. We'll have fun with Joe and Robin, and we need to have somebody bet on Joe and Robin.
Oh, two players, yes. Who do they call, Robin and Larry?
And the phone number would be the Climate Control Source Hotline, which is 622-9622. We'll take a commercial break and take your calls off the air, and we'll be back when we have two players.
If you want to avoid getting ripped off and put more money in your pocket, then join me, Clark Howard, every weeknight at 6, right here on WOCA, The Source.
Look who just walked in the room, Joe Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joe, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joe, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah. whatsupocala.com.
On the next Voice of Ocala, we're live from Cindy's front porch at Mark's Prime Steakhouse, where we'll discuss the Republican Executive Committee's decision concerning a candidate for sheriff of Marion County. Also, Lori Martin Gregory stops by with her Healthy Living segment, and Angie Lewis drops in for her Biz Buzz segment. All that plus sports on the Voice of Ocala on 1370 AM, 96.7 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
This might be a very hard game. We found out two players. George is betting
on... Oh, you say so.
George is betting on Joe. Davis is betting on Robin.
Well, yesterday was a hard game.
Yeah. I guess so. Well, we actually thought this would be easy for you because of your fondness for Disney.
The fondness and paying attention are two different things. You go to Disney, you just kind of absorb everything. You say, okay, I'm a little kitty here, and I'm going to have a lot of fun because I don't care. And I can put the funny hats on and walk around and get burnt, and I don't care. And I get on all the rides, but I got to wait in line.
Did you go to Disneyland, too?
I went to Disneyland in
1971. Can I ask you a question? You've got such a deep voice.
Yes.
And now it's such a high voice.
Yes, it hurts.
Can I ask you to do me a favor?
Sure.
And we'll figure it out later.
Okay.
Give me your lowest note, your lowest possible note.
That would be a D minor.
D minor. Which is a chord. Just go.
Give me the
lowest possible note.
If you want the lowest note, I'd have to come on the first thing in the morning when Galen's episode is on.
Right.
Episode, not segment, episode.
Right.
And then it would be down low. Really low.
That's what I wanted to hear. Now give me a highest one.
You already had the high one.
You can go higher than that? Right now, do this.
Yeah.
In increments as in a major
Do,
scale.
Re, mi, yeah. Fa, sol.
Never mind.
No.
You were skipping. All right.
Of course I skip.
All right, here we go.
And
ready?
Jump rope on the side.
You ready?
I like
jump rope. Here's the song from Walt. These are all pieces of music from Walt Disney World. Robin and Joe.
Walt Disney's rolling over again.
He's like, wow.
Poor man.
Identify where...
He's cool, though.
In the parks.
Yeah,
now, I don't mean, like, Magic Kingdom. That's not good enough. You got to tell me the area.
That
would be crazy.
I thought we were going to get Epcot. You got it. No. It's got to be. Well, I thought it was. No.
All right, so where is.
No, wait a minute. Let me ask you this.
Go ahead.
If it is, let's say, a ride,
uh-huh.
And the music we know is from the ride,
right.
And we give you the ride, and then we tell you which park it's in, do we get a point? Gee.
Yes, you did.
Larry likes that no word. You must have been.
He's tough.
Fantastic.
Larry's
when you were
tough.
2 years old. Terrible tooth. No, it's terrific tooth.
Well, I thought you were going to say if you can tell me the part of the ride you hear it, because some of these rides, the music changes as you go through the ride.
Yes,
oh, that's right.
That's true.
So if you can do that, then I'll take your word for it because I don't know if I have that information.
Dan's saying 2 extra points for that.
2 extra points for that one.
All right, here we go. This is.
Well, I know where you change your shorts. No, never mind.
All right, music from Walt Disney World. Where would you hear this piece?
Is that Main Street?
That is Main Street. Wow, very good.
I let it go.
You can get extra points.
I let that one go. I was enjoying it too much.
Oh, sorry.
I look at her and I'm like, wait, this is nice. And I forgot I was playing the game.
You get an extra point if you tell me who the artist is.
Do you remember when we
Big Crosby.
To the Sousa Band?
Actually, I don't know the singer.
Gee!
I just know the artist as in the on the record label.
Oh.
The artist on the record label?
Well, you know what I mean.
Like RCA?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
If it said Guy Lombardo, it wouldn't tell you who the singer was.
Oh,
so it'd be
okay.
Tommy Dorsey.
Said Guy Lombardo on it.
Oh, so this is Guy
so
Lombardo
he says,
then.
We'll
okay.
let you guess, but I'll give you the answer.
There you go. You hear that when you're on Main Street.
You go,
ah. All right.
Oh, that's the wrong one. That was Lawrence Welk.
All right. Now, here's another one. Let me make sure I take notes so I know which ones I played.
Oh, come on. Make it easy. Play it again.
All right. Here's another one. Where in Walt Disney World would you hear this piece of music?
Jungle Ride.
No.
That's not
Tiki Bird.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Enchanted Tiki Room is right.
Yeah.
Any idea who that might be?
Sergio Mendez in Brazil 66.
Wow, no.
No.
That would be...
good guess.
Yeah, it is a good guess. Henry Mancini.
That's another good guess,
but no.
Well, with the piano, I would say Burt Bacharach
kind of thing.
You know.
Sounds like it.
Oh.
Who is it?
Martin Denny. I don't know if you know
him. Oh, I've heard of him, yes. Believe it or not.
Okay.
Wow.
Believe it or not. It is a good game, believe it or not.
I don't. I hope I have enough of these here.
Well, talk slow.
Where in Disney World would you hear this piece of music?
It's a small world. I'm sorry. It's a small world.
Yeah.
That's Mancini, isn't it?
No.
That's the two guys who put that one together.
Yeah, it is.
From New York. One of the short ones, one of the tall ones. I don't know them. Don't know their name.
Don't worry, do you know? Do you know who did that?
Yeah, The Small World was done by two small guys, Danny DeVito and Tom Cruise.
Oh, that was bad. It was good, but it was bad.
It was done by...
Deflamed!
The Sherman Brothers, it says
The
here.
Sherman Brothers, that's it.
Does that sound familiar?
Yes,
Sherman
it does.
Brothers?
Okay,
that's
does.
It, the Sherman Brothers.
I didn't know that.
Deflamed! Deflamed!
All right, where would you hear...
Yes!
Where would you hear this one right here? Hold on, let me get the number in there. Where would you hear this piece of music in Disney World?
Pirate's Life for me.
Oh, nice.
That stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And you don't have Jack Spade in there now?
That's what I heard, yeah.
Do you switch?
No, that's part of it.
Really?
This is as you're riding in the boat.
Yes, going towards them.
Oh, you got a lifeline.
Jack Sparrow, thank you.
None of us caught that, Tom. Only Tom caught it.
Thank you, Tom.
I
Jack Sparrow.
Jack Sparrow.
See, that's how little we pay attention to these things.
Pay attention to me. Now, wait a minute now. Let's get this right. Well, Tom, stay in that room.
George and Davis are now tied with two.
All right.
Who did the music on that?
That one had no artist mentioned.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That could have been, that could be like in-house kind of people,
Yeah, they never get credit, do they?
No,
yes, they do. In-house credit. Produced by Disney.
Produced by Disney, yeah. Right, here we go. In Disney World, where would you hear this music?
Shining at the end of every day.
GE Carousel of Progress.
Yes.
1964.
Carousel of Progress is right.
The first introduction in 1964 at the New York World's Fair. You went to that one,
wow,
all right.
Wow.
And it has changed. It's not sponsored by GE anymore. And
Is it still there? It's still there.
All three parks. It becomes a reality. Oh, I said three parks. California.
Does that sound like Robert Goulet right there?
It does. There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow. But I don't know if it's him or not. I have no idea. Shining at the end of every
day. There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow. Yeah, I can see the guy sitting on the chair.
Yeah,
the
dog.
All right,
now the next song.
And the burnt turkey at the end. Oh, I gave it away.
I don't know if I have the wrong information or I just never knew the name of this song. It's a familiar song.
Joe will know.
It's a familiar song. I'm going to ask you the title and you could be right.
The title of the song?
Yeah, but most importantly, where it's seen, where you hear it.
I thought it was changing the rules again.
Where you hear it. No. No, because the title of the song throws me, because I never heard the title of this before, but maybe I just am out of it, which is not unusual. Here we go.
It's like time in the morning, yeah, probably.
Here we go. Where would you hear it in Disney World?
Oh, Frontierland.
More specific.
The American Adventure.
Ooh, good guess.
No, not American Adventure.
It's not the American Adventure?
No.
Tom Sawyer Island.
No.
It's the Hall of Presidents.
Hall of Presidents is right.
Wow.
Now, what is the name of this song?
Old Glory.
Yankee Doodle.
Look away.
Oh, it's a medley. It's got to be a medley.
Dixieland.
Okay,
it's got to be a medley.
This is what it said. I did not write it wrong, but this is what the girl I left behind me.
Wow.
Oh.
No?
Okay.
That makes no sense,
doesn't ring
right?
a bell to me. But
no.
Okay, I don't know.
But it's a medley.
Maybe yeah, that's
Hall
the
press. Hall of Presidents, that is an out. Well, for those who have never been, it is outstanding.
Do they keep it up to date? In other words,
yes,
Mr.
Obama, President Obama's in there.
How soon after the election did they put him in there?
They probably have a Mitt Romney animatronics already in there waiting to be produced.
And if he loses, what happens?
They don't put them out.
I mean, do they destroy it?
The president that is elected is displayed the morning after Wow. The inauguration.
There you go.
As soon as the new president's inaugurated, the next morning he is on the.
Wow.
He is in the Hall of Presidents.
Wow, that's amazing.
He or she.
We're talking Disney now. Yes, yeah, we're talking Disney.
Wow, that's amazing.
They've got that set. You know, so the animatronic is back there, the soundtrack set, and he just. They've got it down. They've got it down. You know,
good morning.
So.
You're on the air.
The Girl I Left Behind Me was a song that was popular in the Civil War and the period after that. And if you ever saw that old John Wayne movie about the cavalry called She Wore a Yellow Ribbon,
yeah.
The troopers are singing that song when they march out of the when they ride out of the fort. You'll hear them singing that song.
Oh, sure.
Oh, really?
Wow.
Oh,
wow.
Listen here.
Really, and is that the melody, or is it maybe later on in the song?
It's probably later on in the song.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well. All right. Thank you, Pete.
Well, thank you, Pilgrim.
George and Joe have four, and Davis and I have
right.
two. So call in, Davis.
I forgot we're playing a game. All right, here we go.
Well, I'll be dang. Oh, listen here now.
Here's another piece of music from Walt Disney World. Where would you hear it? In the park.
Is that the Song of the South? Is that the bride with the...
Are you thinking of the patch?
In the Magic Kingdom?
you need to name the ride.
Splash Mountain.
Oh,
Splash Mountain.
Yeah, that's it.
Splash Mountain is right, yes.
Roger, not Roger Rabbit.
The name of the song? You know the name of the song?
What's the name of that rabbit?
Rare Rabbit.
Rare Rabbit. What is it?
He assures you're born.
How do you do? Mighty pleasant meeting you. Well, what's the name of it?
The Disney Player?
It's called How Do You Do? I don't
oh,
know.
Oh, it is called How. I'm saying
that
he ignored me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Point.
Did I? All right.
Did you? Just for that, this is WOCA Ocala, the source of your entertainment on my dime. Yes. I tell you what.
Can we have one day where it's a Fun with Joe marathon where it's just like from 7 till noon?
The listeners would love that.
As long as I get bathroom breaks, coffee, and food.
My mom loves this. My mom loves this.
Yeah,
segment,
she
brother.
Loves watching you. You're so animated.
All right, here we go.
Great.
Here we go.
I've been called worse. Yes.
I think this ride is no
it's
longer
Wendy.
There.
Hey, Wendy!
She's
on the phone. Forget about it.
This ride is no longer there.
Oh.
Are you ready?
20,000 Leagues Under the Sea.
You got it.
Wow.
Bam!
Here's the music from it.
John Williams?
It is not John Williams, but do you know the song?
From Here to Eternity. No.
Oh. Now, do you remember hearing this when you were on that ride?
Yes.
You do?
No, I don't.
Believe it or not, from 71.
Really?
I don't think I went. I didn't go to the one here in Florida, but they closed it down by the time I got back here. I'm going down. Brought to you by Larry does that every once
that
in a while.
That was the song title was Captain Nemo's Theme.
Oh, okay.
And Paul J. Okay. Smith is giving credit.
I remember going there, and the thing I remember is seeing some kind of a serpent with his eyes going either way, going
oh, really?
Like,
yeah.
going
yeah.
like cockeyed, you know,
well, well, it's,
underwater.
It's trivia: while they were under construction, and they were constructing up Thunder Mountain, when they were doing the trial run of the. Banks for the roller coaster and stuff. It,
uh-huh.
flew off the track. It went right into the lagoon.
Before the park
opened.
Before,
yeah.
This is
yeah,
where.
They,
oh, wow.
California or here?
No, right here, Disney World.
Wow.
Thunder Mountain.
And tell everybody how you know that.
Well, how do you know that?
Because Ronnie built Epcot, and he was one of the union guys that worked on Epcot from the ground up. And
Epcot?
Was one of the,
wow.
Yeah, and he was one of the
Ronnie,
union
Robert's
guys
husband.
That worked
yeah.
in the Magic Kingdom for the different.
So that's back in 71, 60, 69, 70, 71.
Yeah.
It was open 71, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Uh-oh.
Are you ready?
Yeah,
she
so.
Shouldn't have told me
so
that.
So can you imagine, he was there when it just looked like a construction site.
Yeah.
So, but did he ever see Disney himself? Because Disney died largely before it ever opened. Or
no, because the first, Walt Disney himself, no.
Walt Disney, no. Okay.
No, never did.
Okay, yeah.
I bet you didn't even see Mickey Mouse in those days.
No.
No, it was all behind the scenes. Mickey wouldn't help.
That.
No, no, Mickey wouldn't
yeah.
help. Definitely not.
All right, here we go. What song, not what song, but where in Disney World would you hear this one?
Silver Palace.
No.
Oh, good guess. The Bowery is the name of the song, but who would do this?
What's the name of the song?
The Bowery, right?
The Bowery? That's the name of the song, Larry?
This is a medley again.
It's listed as a medley, yeah, so it doesn't
Where
give that
would this
time.
Be? Oh, Frontierland.
No.
It's a good old summertime. In the good old. The Great American Adventure, then.
No.
Oh, Tom Sawyer Island.
Okay, it's in that area, so it's got to be Main Street.
Are we in
Main
the right
Street
area?
Is right. Main Street is right. Yeah. Good morning. You're on the air. Oh, so maybe they were going to guess.
I'm Main sorry.
Street. Yeah, they were going to guess.
That's how I ate. But I got to work for George. I'm sorry, you know.
George is 8. Davis has 2.
I don't know who did that.
All right, here's another.
He's ignoring me.
Who did it? Who did it?
3 times.
The Paratime Ragtime Orchestra.
Oh.
The Paratime Ragtime Orchestra.
Cool. Oh, okay.
At least they're getting credit. I like that.
All right, here's another song from Walt Disney World. Where in the parks would you hear it?
Jamboree. The Bear Jamboree.
Yeah, wow, very good. Yeah.
That's scary, isn't it?
It is scary, scary, yeah. The Country Bear Jamboree. And any idea what the song is called?
Ooh, there's
an
accordion in there.
Huh?
The accordion's in it, she said.
Oh, yeah, right. It's called Bearless Love. Bearless
Love.
Oh. Ooh. Clever.
Now, this piece is beautiful, and I don't remember ever hearing it, and I went on this ride many times. Where would I have heard this?
That's not the Jungle Ride, is it? No, Jungle Ride has no music. No. Oh, it's there.
Oh, Peter Pan's Flight.
No, good guess. It does have beautiful music.
Oh, it's there, the tip of my tongue.
Is the ride still there?
Yes, I think it is. That's not Soarin'.
No, not Soarin', no.
No, this is an older ride.
Yes, an older ride, yes.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Want help from the audience?
Yeah. What kingdom is it in?
It's in Epcot.
Oh, Epcot.
That's why.
Epcot. Oh, Norway.
No, that's
Norway. Yeah, wrong. Oh, yeah, wrong. Okay. Wrong. Okay. He didn't say right or wrong.
All right.
Epcot. Give me wait.
Give me a second. All right.
Give me a sec now.
All right.
I'm going through with my brain in here right now.
Right.
It's not in the golf ball.
It is in the golf ball.
Is that the golf ball?
Wow.
Spaceship Earth is what it's called.
I
called it the golf ball.
Who's the winner, Robin?
Oh, George with 10 and
all
Davis
right, George,
with 2. I'm so sorry.
Hey, let's do this again on Monday. What do you think?
Fun.
Or tomorrow. I'm sorry.
Tomorrow.
My days are rolling.
Well, you're having girls' night out, so I can understand. You might not be here tomorrow.
Oh, my. You are definitely going to hang me.
Scream in the door.
Oh, all the Haunted Mansion, yes.
Strange and frightening.
All right, we've got to go. Mike Huckabee.
Oh, Jay.
You don't want to go to Mike Huckabee.
No, I'm having so much fun. Sorry, Mike, but okay, we'll go to you.
Where the air is deathly still.
I think anticipating quite a night for there. You know, it's going to be fascinating because Joe Biden, who really is a pretty doggone good debater, is also a guy that tends to walk onto the stage, open his mouth, and put both feet in somewhere during the course of the speech. We just love him for that because he gives us so doggone much material. And we deeply appreciate him. And the only reason that I would have some comfort if Obama were reelected, and there would be very little to be sure, because I think it would be terrible for the country, but it would be great for talk radio because he continues to supply so much material for us. Now, let me quickly tell you that I would gladly give up the material to get the country back. But I do think Biden is going to be on his best behavior tonight, and I don't think he's going to do anything really ridiculous. My guess is they've had him sequestered for 6 days for a reason. He's probably been wired to a chair, and they have extracted certain words from his vocabulary and try to make very sure that he's going to behave and be a big boy tonight.
Mr. Joe Biden. Gaffe.
Yep, we'll be watching for a gaffe, but may not get one. We do know he can connect with people, and that's what they're going to send him out there to do and try to make up for the disastrous performance of the president last week. Paul Ryan's never been on a stage quite like this one before. He certainly had debates, but never the focus and attention and the intensity. And not since, of course, he's been nominated as VP has he had anything like this kind of direct confrontation with Joe Biden. So I think he can more than hold his own. It's just going to be a fascinating night. Of course, tomorrow we'll be here to give you all the analysis. If you don't get to watch it, don't worry. We will help you understand, interpret it, have the highlights, and a complete breakdown of what happened. This hour, we want to focus a great deal on what I call some of the big lies and big cover-ups.